when you get here, get loud, get crazy, and maybe the team will do something.
Teachers were not the only people walking picket lines on this eighth day of the New Orleans teacher strike. Several students, as well as parents from Ben Franklin High, for example, joined the protest in front of school board headquarters this afternoon following classes. Armed with signatures and a petition bearing signatures of some 300 students, the youngsters say the board should know the students are tired of the strike and they want their own teachers back.
Students at Ben Franklin High School took a course outside the classroom today.
As Sally Ann Roberts reports, they learned a lesson from their teachers about walking the picket line.
Get in line!
Get in line! Come on! Drop your books!
With the fervor of a pep squad, Ben Franklin High School students donned picket signs that said, among other things, "We don't pick our scabs." The students made it clear they stand with their teachers against the school board and against teachers who cross the picket line.
We're out here because we're concerned about our education, and we want to show our teachers that we support what they stand for, improving the schools, higher raises, respect from both the community and the school board.
The students picketed with their teachers for about 20 minutes before the opening of school and then went off to class as usual. Teachers at Franklin and schools citywide remained on the line. Frank Turner has the latest.
The parents and the students will suffer once more.
It was bandwagon day in the teacher strike, with a group of parents and city council members jumping on the one calling for an end to the walkout. Parent organizations from a list of schools met to demand both sides come to the table and stay there. An agreement, they say, must come soon.
As each day passes, our students are suffering all over Orleans Parish for the lack of attention to their educational well-being and their emotional health.
By the time parents got the wagon rolling, others were already on it, with the mayor and the council formally asking both sides to work it out.
It was solidarity.
No.
It's quite the word. The name of the game is solidarity.
No, I know. Listen, I was a leader of the strike in 78. All your rhetoric, I know already.
This is really bad for the students because, you know, we're not getting the education we came to Franklin for. However, you know, I really sympathize with the teachers because, you know, they ought to be paid a lot more.
All I can say is that for 15 years, I have worked as hard as I can, devoting as much energy and as much intelligence as I can bring to this job on behalf of students who are my top priority. And that at moments like this, students must judge their teachers not only by what teachers say, but by what teachers do.
Feel about the strike? Well, they had a choice to make. I had a choice to make, and that's all it boils down to.
I just hope that when it's over with, we can get together and that everybody can understand that everybody has to do what they believe they have to do.
Hi, I'm Catherine Kitchen.
And I'm Micah Ferris.
And welcome to FTV.
Last Wednesday, October 10th, College Night was held here at school. Representatives from over 100 colleges were here to attend. We're at hand to talk about to the students and to give general information. The following footage was shot by Jonathan Jones.
I see the does not mean you're going to be out of the running for honors.
Where is that?
Yes.
It's located about 38 miles east of Atlanta. Are you familiar with Atlanta? Yeah. Can you go out?
Hi.
How are you?
Harvard did not show up.
Where's University of Southern California? Look, and you will see.
The following footage was filmed by Mr. Warner, Shira Kansas, and Jennifer Rolt.
Yesterday, Franklin began Spirit Week with Banner Day. All class banners are hung in the front hall. Today is dress-up day, and tomorrow will be Franklin Color Day in the canned food drive. Thursday is class t-shirt day, and Friday will be the Olympics and the class skit and class song. Everybody should sign up to participate to show spirit for your class.
Come on, y'all have some spirit.
substitute teachers. We're all going to walk out and sit in front of school, and we might even call the TV station. It's going to happen.
Oh,
beneath your fingernail?
Well, I love you, you dope.
Well, if you love me, will you get the hell out of here?
It was better than cats.
You have the word of the President of the United States. Cross my heart, hope to die.
Just look in the window seat.
Remember the time you...
Again and again. I loved it.
Thank you, gentlemen, at ease.
I'm representing the third period Freedom Prize class. We are selling a cycloid t-shirt, and since there have been many questions of what is a cycloid, we are going to have a few members of our classroom tell you what a cycloid means to them.
The arc here cuts the circle in half, which forms an oblique triangle with a curved base. That's the cycloid.
We like it because it's fashionable. You can sport with jeans or as a dress.
It was very much time for him, you know, for him to meet me and everything.
Taking advantage of the situation and have made ourselves look undeserving of this new building by creating a great litter problem around the area.
The main thing we're concerned about is the trash at lunchtime. Both this, we have to be more responsible and more mature in our cleaning up after ourselves.
Fran Meserly, Sr. states her opinion.
Well, for a bunch of smart people, we litter a lot. I mean, considering that we know that somebody's got to pick it up, and chances are it's going to be us.
Dr. Chu's principal, and Aparna Rayo, Jr., offer some suggested explanations for a growing problem.
It is that we live in New Orleans, and New Orleans people tend to litter a great deal, and we all grow up in that environment.
I think the reason a lot of people litter is just because they're too lazy to find a garbage can. But if you don't have time now, then before you know it, everything's, the whole world's going to be all messed.
There are those that are trying to help out.
I certainly applaud the student government for working at it, and some individual students who came to me one fifth hour and just walked me out into the courtyard and talked about how disgusted they were with the whole thing.
There's always a trash can near, begging to be used.
Just do it. Clean up.
Four minutes is done. You sure know a lot about life. Where'd you learn it?
In the choir loft.
Mortimer
and Elaine are going to be married.
There's a body in there.
Well, yes, dear, we know. I take one teaspoonful of arsenic, then a half teaspoonful of strychnine, and then just a pinch of cyanide.
Here it is!
Good morning and welcome to FTV. I'm Jenny Sands.
And I'm Catherine Kitchen.
The boys and girls basketball teams played St. James last Friday. The girls won and the boys lost, but both teams played very well. The following footage of the game was filmed by Jonathan Jones.
The Ben Franklin girls soccer game was held at the Fly on Wednesday, December 12th. Ben Franklin destroyed McMaine 5-0. The Franklin scores were made by Leah Bauer and Jennifer Wessel. Leah Bauer scored 3 goals and Jennifer Wessel scored 2 goals. Through teamwork and accurate execution, Franklin was obviously in complete control of the game. Because of this victory, the Ben Franklin girls soccer team now remains undefeated. With this strong team, Ben Franklin has a very good chance of entering the playoffs. Congratulations to the girls soccer team for an outstanding victory. This is Samuel Howard for FTV.
I want a car.
I want for Christmas, but I hope it's good.
We have this problem in the Middle East settled and all of our young men and women come home.
Is all the soldiers who are in Kuwait to be home with their families?
Hey, I want good grades.
Pray there, dude.
What on peace?
Yeah.
your New Year's resolution?
To make junior nationals and all the friends.
To get higher than a C on this one.
What do you want? What's your New Year's resolution?
Never to eat a moon pie again in my
life. New Year's resolution is to stop making fun of people, to make her mine.
Yes, I'm standing here next to Jared King, who took second place in the engineering department of the science fair. Jared, if you could tell us a little bit about your project.
Yes, I simply built three models of three common bridge designs, and through my research, made two models of my own design. And I tested each one for strength and any stress factors that may be involved due to pressure that a bridge must withstand during daily usage.
Well, congratulations and good luck in district. And there are a new set of science projects here today that will be judged at about 9 a.m. I strongly urge everyone to come see them. They are really fascinating.
Red roses too, I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Frosty skies of blue and clouds of white. A bright, blessed day.
You don't need any equipment, it's completely free.
And it's a lot of fun.
Congratulations to the varsity soccer team who made it to the state semifinals this year. They were defeated by Episcopal after a hard game, but everyone is extremely proud of their effort and talent they displayed this season. The following footage was shot in Lafayette by Jenny Sands. Thank them for a wonderful season.
Hi. You're the ball. He's gonna have to hand it to him over there. Get it.
SWEEP, Students Working for Environmental and Ethical Progress, has been in existence for close to 1 year now. In that 1 year, SWEEP has managed to broaden its goals into four basic branches. One is an animal rights group, another is a wetlands and rainforest group, a third one is for the homeless, and the fourth one is for recycling. On February 14th, Kate Radlow came to talk to us about wetlands in Louisiana.
Members of the drama club performed a collection of one-act plays entitled Shorts and Briefs.
Oh, they shall be seen electric. And they forget to hold them. Oh. That one came out pretty neat.
Oh my God. I
I'm on stage in an opera.
See it? The island, the contentious.
Look at all those people!
Hey, notice any difference?
No.
I'm wearing a bra.
I'm never going to wear one.
Do you think I should get rid of it?
I forgot! I completely forgot we were in a minefield!
Still are, no thanks to you.
So what's going on, Rose? Can't you tell me? I'm gonna have a baby.
Rose?
Yes.
My God.
Yes.
When?
8 months, I guess.
How about your answers, Alice?
What?
Don't you better start writing something when I have a chance of passing this!
Oh, no!
What's the matter?
I'm almost done! I haven't written down anything!
Well, have you tried all the questions?
No! None of those folks are so ugly, their parents make them go underground.
All students can try out. No parts are precast.
Well, she was good, you know what I mean.
Picture yourself in this show.
Wonder what she's doing now.
Then we made our true love last.
Auditions are Monday, March 4th at 3:30 in the auditorium. Be there.
Seems, but, the summer
Congratulations to the Computer Science AP students who came in second at a programming contest held at Northeastern Louisiana University. Team members Tahir Dakota, Martin Galliano, and Brian Roundhill each won $50, and the team received a plaque for their achievement.
Now students will also be able to remember from this building, and those of you that were fortunate enough to be in this other building will also have dual memories.
This proclamation reads, be it known that the mayor of New Orleans this day proclaimed March 8, 1991 to be Benjamin Franklin High School Day is signed by Mayor Sidney J. McFarlane and dated to the city of the city.
We must build all of our schools like Ben Franklin.
Walked out on the field and the cheerleaders started cheering. Retard them. They don't believe it's the steroid.
Franklin developed from a dream of optimum education. An atmosphere of learning and of betterment of oneself was instilled in the school. And all our lack were the facilities. But now we have that which we never had before, and nothing should come in the way of our achieving all of our goals.
Dear God, it is said that without vision, the people perish. Thus let us leave this place which has been dedicated for the education of our future with a renewed vision, both personal enough to warrant our personal dedication, yet universal enough to transcend our own individualistic concerns. Amen.
Last Wednesday was Franklin's annual physics dress-ups day. Mr. Nirenberg students dressed in creative costumes portraying various physics concepts.
What are you?
Sleep.
An object at rest. Human inertia.
My hair all messed
up. Nina, what are you?
I'm a magnet.
Ah!
Zoom, zoom, zoom.
The Red Cross is now responsible for all recycling here at Franklin. They ask that you please drain your can and rinse them thoroughly. Then crush them.
Go for it.
And place them in the proper receptacle.
Basketball game in the gym. The game was exciting and all who played had a great time. Jennifer Rault captured the girls' victory on film.
Okay, I'm Patricia.
I'm Lutz.
I'm Chris.
I'm Sascha.
I'm Michaela.
I'm Derek.
Lars.
Okay.
They're from the Clay Oberschule in Berlin, which is in a district called Neukölln, which in English is New Cologne. They go to a school which is named after an American general who served in Berlin during the Berlin blockade in 1948, named Lucius Clay.
How is Ben Franklin different than your school?
Oh, in our class, we would never be allowed to eat or to talk and put the foot on the chair or on the table.
First of all, in Germany, we work according to a weekly schedule and not to a daily schedule as the Americans do. And I think the teaching methods are quite the same.
That's the Reichstag, the former seat of the parliament in Germany. And we hope that because of the reunification, it will become the seat of parliament again. I think this picture speaks for itself. And this is the Brandenburger Tor from the western side, picture taken from the western side, and the wall is in front of the Brandenburger Tor. It was, it has been removed up to now, the wall.
Everybody was happy, everybody was waiting that the wall would come down. And especially I went to the Brandenburg Gate on 22nd of December last year when the wall came down that spot, and it was just thousands of people who were streaming into former East Berlin, so it was not really chaos, but crowded, really crowded.
I think to speak English is easier than to learn German, and there's not a really barrier.
Daryl, how do you feel about it the opposite way?
The opposite way? I found that there is absolutely no language barrier. If we don't know what we're talking about, then we don't know what we're talking about, and we wave our hands and jump up and down. Eventually the point gets across and we understand each other.
No,
thank you.
Desk today, two trophies. They belong to the academics team, who won first place in propaganda and third place in Mr. President's game nationally.
Ben Franklin Wagner.
West Virginia.
He is from West Virginia. That is correct. Conversation, which comes?
Ben Franklin Elmwood.
Coffee Klatch.
Coffee Klatch, from the German word meaning chat. Another 10, please. On which side of a man's shirt are the buttons?
Left.
No, they're on the right. On which side of the pant or skirt is the belt buckle located?
Underside.
One. Answer?
The left.
That's correct. Ben Franklin, 270. And Country Day, 145.
Honor Society is one of the highest honors bestowed upon high school students.
by the UN delegate, senior class secretary, and the drama book. And every time they are part of the current position list. So Yearbook, he also did well in the computer programming contest, Science Olympiad, and the jet ski.
Allison Ever, also All-American. be spontaneous. Go up there and just do it.
Brandon, just turn and smile for the public here.
Lot of the environment, but I think whatever's going to become of it, we're going to have to make it what it was in the old buildings. But
the main thing I like is the proximity to my home and also the air conditioning. That's the number one thing. The newness doesn't bother me too much. it's the air conditioning. So it puts a few years on my life since I don't have to perspire so much.
I like my classroom a lot more than that little church room I was in.
Well, I really like the new facilities and everything, but I miss the atmosphere of the old school.
FTV would like to say goodbye to the graduating class of 1991. We'll miss you and best of luck in the future.
Thank you for joining us. That's the news, and we are out of here.
Mr. Stanley Schofield. When David called and said, can you come and give a few remarks? I said, no. He said, but you've got to. I said, no. He said, please. I said, okay. To the parents, I promised your kids that tonight you would buy them any and everything they want. So tonight, I want you to buy anything and everything at Piccadilly's. And in my case, I'm hoping there's some young person who will go on to medical school and go into research that will be, he or she will be the discoverer of a pill that you could take overnight and lose 40 pounds. But enjoy this night. For Ben Franklin, you've endeavored to beat the odds. I'm so proud of you. I'm so happy for you. And God bless you. Thank you very much.
Now for our salutatory address given by Tex or Mark Thompson.
All right, Franklin, class of 1991. We made it. We tested the limits of human endurance, and we lost a few of our compatriots. But we toughed it out and have finally, officially finished our last year of high school. The alternative to action is to sit back and let everything get worse, to leave government to the experts in their ivory towers, in their white houses, the experts who brought you the bureaucracy of the welfare system, the war in Vietnam, and a $1 trillion deficit. I think our choice is clear.
Makes education tick. Well, as a friend reminded me on the last day of school, hey, congrats, only 8 to 10 more years of higher education until our PhDs. Because as Emerson once said, nothing great was ever achieved without enthusiasm. And I think right here we have the best example of that, the class of 91. Thank you for being a great class.
And now for the presentation of the Superintendent's Award for Academic Excellence.
To your salutatorian, Mark Thompson, on behalf of our superintendent, Everett J. Williams, we present you with this plaque. Congrats, Mark. Best of luck to you. From our superintendent, Everett J. Williams, the plaque for the valedictorian. Best of luck to the class of 91.
And now the presentation of the Benjamin Franklin Key Award.
The Franklin Key Award is sponsored by the Alumni Association and is presented annually to the student who best exemplifies the spirit and broad-based excellence of Ben Franklin. Graduate we have chosen is David Siskum.
Because you, in the class of 1991, are charged with the responsibility of leadership in the coming century, your approach to education is extremely important to the future health and welfare of America. Congratulations once again, and I wish all of you God's eternal blessing.
Now, Dr. McKenna and Dr. Jefferson, these students of the class of 1991 at Benjamin Franklin High School have fulfilled all of their obligations and passed all of the tests for graduation and for receiving a diploma. So I recommend them to you for graduation. Peter, Jennifer Ann Bass, Claudia Bosch, Leah Milana Bauer, Gregory Thomas Benton, Julie Michelle Barron, Maxwell F. Michelle Borden, Jane Spil, Natasha Marie Briggs, Brendan Wade Brown, Claire. Rebecca Rose, Vivian Elizabeth, John Paul Collins, Michael Ellis Cox, Cynthia G. Daniel.
Thank you.
completes the presentation of diplomas to the Franklin Class.
The loafers, the lazy, the loners, the losers, but all of them the loved.